given birth. That mystery is unfolding, and as it keeps going, as the mystery is unfolding, the things of the earth, it's involved with the things of the earth. Say, for example, I think 9/11 was a part of the unfolding of the mystery of God. What? Really? Yeah. I can't put it all together, but I think it's starting to unfold some of the mystery of God. Some of the world that has never heard the gospel, had never had a white person on that land. I do say white, Caucasian, on that land. And you know, when they show up, guess what they bring? The gospel. All the Catholic churches, all of them coming in here, and they may not have it down to perfection, but they bring in that Bible with them, versus that Islam stuff and all that. So, they say, things starting unfolding. When Paul and Peter was walking through the earth during the time of the book of Acts, the world is kind of unfolding, making way for the gospel to be presented. Now, what the gospel is presenting, it presents two things: everlasting life through believing in faith in Jesus Christ, and now that you have that faith in Jesus Christ, you got the covenant promises of Abraham. Many folks don't preach that. They just preach the death, burial, and resurrection of Jesus Christ. Get saved here on the earth, live miserable, and go to heaven. No, the gospel of Jesus is you get saved, you believe in what Jesus Christ has done for you, and guess what? Get aware of that Abrahamic covenant. You are now adopted into the family. You're that branch that came and replaced those old branches that got plucked out because it was in unbelief. Ooh. Okay, praise God. So, that's what's going on. I'm moving real fast. I know time is short. When the fullness of time was come, the apostles was able to walk and travel the earth unrestricted because it was just politically okay. The world was at peace at that time. You could come and go anytime, anywhere you want to. Your travels was unrestricted from one country to another country. So they just went around preaching the gospel. Conditions was just right. And 9/11, the first Sunday after 9/11, was it a good time to preach? Conditions was right. Even yesterday was what? Conditions was right.
Right.
How many people went to church yesterday and ain't been there in a while? Hadn't seen the inside of the sanctuary. Oh, is that what church looks like on the inside? Is that what a choir is? Some of the announcers or broadcasters, boy, look at that. I didn't know all that was going on over up in there.
Some of the black announcers said that's common every Sunday.
That's all the time. Yeah, they do that all the time. Yeah, just like that. Because that's sometimes some people have seen inside the church.
Yeah.
What's going on?
This is what we do.
All right. So God makes the condition. As He unfolds His mystery, sometimes the conditions on the ground is just right for Him to let me do it right now. Boom. That's called grace. This is the best time to get their attention. Right now. Let me do it right now. That's what was happening. The birth of Jesus, the resurrection of Jesus, the preaching of His resurrection, all of that is done in favorable conditions. Right now, we're in favorable conditions. We're in grace. God doing for us. A preacher ain't a preacher without what? Grace. Let me tell you that right now. You try and witness somebody without grace. You try and talk to somebody, you need to be good for the Lord without grace. They'll cut your throat. Steal your car, key your car, cut your hair. Because the conditions is not right. What is the condition? God working behind the scenes, fixing it up. This is the perfect time for you to talk to your co-worker, your classmate. Mm-hmm. Perfect time to think. Why? Well, this is the way things are on the ground right now. This is the best time to do it. He gives you the unction to now do it. And then you try and do it without grace, without that anointing, without that inspiration, without that spirit, without that inner strength, you're going to fall flat on your way. Grace. That's why it is the gospel is right now. Grace is what's working. Okay, now, verse 5 of chapter 4. To redeem them that were, what? Under the law, that we might receive the, what? Adoption of the sons. Once you get saved, you get immediate adoption into the Jewish family. So now you got to start switching the pickles in Jesus.
22
Yeah, so you can close your pickles. The meat that you need.
Sound you're trying to bring the law back.
Oh, that's right. We're under grace. Eat what you want to eat. That was the argument they had last week. What you eating? You sit down with them when they eat that stuff. Now when you bring them into public, you act like you don't know those people. What's up with you? That's not God's love. That was Paul calling out another preacher. Sometimes preachers act like they don't know nothing about grace. So, I believe in Jesus Christ as my Lord and Savior. Automatically, I get adopted into the Jewish family. I'm automatically planted into that tree. And whatever comes up from the root, comes up through the tree system, catches me as a branch. Now, the question is, what's in the root system? The root system is God. And it travels from the tree up to the branches. What am I getting out of the root system? If the root system is heaven itself, what am I actually experiencing? Life first. Life. Mm-hmm. What about everlasting life? Automatically. Mm-hmm. Right now. You got as much life as you ever going to win. That's a mystery. Yeah, you got all the life you're going to get. You ain't alive now, you ain't going to be later. Jesus said it in so many words. In me is life. Life continues in me. But if a man dies and don't believe in me, what? Death begins. Life begins the moment you believe. Now I'm believing, life is eternal. You got all life you're going to get. So that's coming up from the root system. What's up in heaven? Well, we got some cancer up there.
No.
We got some whatever. Some other bad stuff up there. It's broke. Instead of streets of gold, streets of asphalt.
No.
No. Every good thing is up there. And it's coming from that root system and it's getting to you, the branch, unless you cut off. You're broken off. But no, you were grafted in. Because you are sons, because you've been adopted, God set forth the spirit of his son into your heart. Whereby thou art no more a what? Servant. You don't have no more babysitters. You don't have no more nannies. But you're in control of your inheritance. You can decide when you get broke.
Or not.
You can decide how broke you're going to be.
Or not.
You can decide how safe you want. You can decide how much peace, love, happiness, everything. The only creatures that can't change their destiny is an animal. Well, birds fly south when it's what? In North America, they fly south when? When it gets cold in North America, they go south. What if conditions are not so good down there? Can they change around and say, we're going back north? They keep going south. They can't change. With you, if life is going south, you can say, hey, it's time to go north. Turn it around. We're the only ones that can turn it around. You can determine how much faith and blessings you get. You can turn life in your favor. All of it. We're out of here. I have to charge extra.